For joining the Dr. J Show. The J in Dr. J stands for Jesus. We are unashamedly about the gospel. This program exists to broadcast the name of Jesus to the nations. Wherever you're watching, peace be with you. I laminate the screen with the blood of Jesus. As you watch me, you're watching me through the eyes of the Holy Ghost. You're watching me through the lenses of the blood of Jesus. Holy Spirit, come and take control. Power of the Godhead, we welcome you. Spirit of the living God, we bow at your feet. The revelation behind every rhema, we enthrone you. In this studio tonight, oh God, I enthrone you. Welcome, viewers. Thank you so much for joining me. My name is Pastor Sandra Uba, your hostess in the next for the next hour, bringing you the best program ever yet that we have ever done. Dr. J Show exists as game-changing television. We are unapologetically about the gospel. We exist to broadcast the name of Jesus to the whole of the world. We are broadcasting Jesus to the nations. It's a masterpiece of this era. On this show, you will encounter God in a different way, in a new way, in a better way, in a way that galvanizes your spirit man into action. Spirit of the living God, the power behind my speaking out loud, come and take control. I diminish that you can amplify yourself, oh God. I reduce that you can amplify yourself, oh God. Absolutely take control. The word of Psalm 45:2 says that God has poured grace upon my lips. God is the most handsome of all men. That God has poured grace upon my lips, and therefore God has blessed me forever. I testify. Indeed, tonight I come to you with engraced lips, engraced mouths, engraced with the fire of God, engraced by the Spirit of the living God. Every word I speak has been backed up by the throne room, by God himself. So I urge you, come with an open heart, come with an open mind, come, sit, de-ogai yourself, de-madam yourself, de-big man yourself, de-auntie yourself. Come with your heart open, ready to receive. In the way that I've always presented this program, I encourage you to see the Holy Spirit like a moving river. You know, those of us who have lived in Africa, remember this. Even if you didn't do it yourself personally, at least watching Nollywood and some of these films that we have from Africa must have played this drama out before your eyes. The river flowing. If you go to the river with a bucket, you get a bucket amount of money. If you amount of water, if you go to the river with a tanker, put the nozzle in, you get a tanker worth of water. If you go to a river with a spoon, you get a spoonful's amount. Why am I saying that to you? It's actually a story I used to hear from Daddy Adeboye himself. Whenever he does his Festival of Light in Excel, UK, he always says that the Holy Spirit is like a river. Now, it's entirely up to you what you get from this session. As you have joined us, thank you so much once again. I am going to present a wonderful show before you. We are going to be, I'm going to be giving you highlights of what happened in Manchester. Manchester, of course, last week, the 6th and 7th of April, we had the person, Grace was in the house, the person of Apostle Professor Johnson Suleiman was in the house, and I'm going to be bringing to you highlights of the Manchester, in particular, the interview that the Lord granted Dr. Jesus Show the opportunity to be, to undertake. It was his first interview ever in the United Kingdom, first interview ever on any stage. In terms of doing his program, normally he comes, does his thing, and he goes. But to the glory of God of Israel, oh God, I worship you. God, I salute you. You, the doer of the impossible. You that took me from nothing to something. 1 minute I was on the ground like mere mortals. Next minute I was climbing the stage to talk with the great man. Ah, Father, I am grateful. Thank you for that opportunity. I'm going to bring before you, viewers, that interview, 16, 17 minutes of it. Who am I to get 16, 17 minutes, almost 20 minutes of the time of the great man of God? Oh, Grace was in the house. Certainly, I would not have gotten that interview if the finger of God didn't orchestrate it. By the right hand of God, which is power, by the finger of God, there shall be a stirring in this program, this session. The grace of God that mantled me, the grace of God that stood me out from the throng, the grace of God that stood me out from the thousands, the grace of God that afforded me that opportunity to sit eyeball to eyeball, face to face, microphone to microphone, to Apostle Johnson Suleiman, shall possess you tonight as you're watching in the name of Jesus. I'm going to bring you highlights from the Manchester program. I'm going to be using this whole program to give praise to God. It's a huge, huge, huge testimony. before Manchester, about 3 weeks ago, I was writing down my prayer points. And on my prayer point, the first item on my list was that, oh God, it would be wonderful if I can get an interview opportunity with this great man, oh God. I wrote down 5 minutes. God took my 5 minutes and multiplied it by almost four. And he gave me that miracle. Miracle of open door. Miracle of apostolic interview being granted to me. I am so grateful, oh God. I am using this program to thank the Lord. I'm also going to be using this program to do something extra special. His other half, the person, the first lady of Omega Fire Ministries, Dr. Mrs. Elizabeth Johnson Suleiman, is in the UK. She, in particular, is here for a very special program. She storms London for the Mother's Blessings program. On Sunday, I'm going to be giving you the address much later. I'm going to be availing to you the information much later. All I ask you to do is to keep your ears peeled, get your pen, get your paper, keep your eyes focused on screen, get your mobile phone. As at the time I'm giving you the information, take pictures. Absolutely, you will not regret it. Dr. Mrs. Elizabeth Johnson Suleiman is in town to give us a second dosage of that grace. Amen. Her husband went to Manchester. She's in London. So please, listen out, ladies. Listen out, gentlemen. Grace is in London, and grace must impart itself unto you in Jesus' name. Amen. And as is our fine tradition in this program, I'm going to be taking phone calls, doing live prayers. As at the time that the phone lines are open, I will notify you of the telephone number that you call. So please, on the double, be on standby. It's a packed agenda tonight. So without further ado, this is where I would like to entreat you to please cast your eye on the television for this wonderful interview that took place with Apostle Johnson Suleiman in Manchester, live on the stage of University of Salford Maxwell Hall. That building was where we held the Dr. Jesus Show, held the first ever interview with Apostle Johnson Suleiman. It was unscripted, it was unplanned. The Holy Spirit took control, the Holy Spirit had his way. It was absolutely wonderful. Several people have come to me and asked me, did you plan it? I did not. It was nothing but the finger of God. Oh, God, I bless you. The God that did it for me. The God that took me from absolutely nothing to absolutely something. I give you the glory. I give you the praise. I pray for you as you watch this program that the God that did it for me will also do it for you. So without further ado, this is where I entreat the broadcast engineer to please indulge you that's watching at home. I present to you the interview with Apostle Johnson Suleiman live on stage in Manchester on the 7th of April, 2016. Welcome, enjoy.
We have answers from the set man of the house. By all means, show your contribution. Amen. The very first question, sir. The Eat This Easter program has benefited people in the North, Manchester particularly. And the questions that Londoners are asking is, what of London? We are used to you coming to meet us in London twice a year, at least. Officially, what of September to remember? Please tell us.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. When the things of the Spirit are not stereotyped.
Hello.
When it's spiritual, then you cannot stereotype it. It doesn't have to be a particular pattern. You walk by the Spirit of God in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gives an instruction, you go by it. So we are under guidance, we are under leadership. When you are under the dictates of a leader, you only carry out the instructions that your leader gives you. So I believe it's time for Manchester. When it's time for London, it will be London.
Amen. Show your applause. Amen. Thank you so much for that answer. We have 10 minutes for this session, and I cut to the chase again very quickly. Going forward, what next for Manchester? Are we expecting this to be an every April event? Are we expecting it to be a once a year event? Is this one of Manchester would like to know?
When next you're coming to Manchester,
there will be if a at all.
Yeah. I believe there is no move of God as a one-off thing. Every move of God beams towards another move.
Yes, sir.
So when God has sent us to Manchester now, definitely, if he starts a thing, he'll complete it. So definitely, we'll come again.
Amen. Glory to God. Aren't you happy to hear that news? Show your gratitude. A round of applause. There are a number of people here today who have joined us from other ministries, very notable ministries and very unknown ministries in some instances. And there's a question that's coming out. How old is Omega Phi Ministries? People are asking that question. Help us.
Omega Phi Ministries officially is 12 years old.
Hallelujah.
Every ministry began before the foundation of the world. But officially, Omega Phi Ministries started on 1st of February 2004. Officially, so as at February, we were about 12 years old.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A round of applause. And so far, how many countries thus far does Omega have a physical presence in?
As my last count, which was like a couple of months ago, over 45 countries.
Hallelujah. Given that this commission started 12 years ago, what a wonderful thing. Show your appreciation for the young countries in knowledge of. Amen. Now, we have so many notable sayings from you. In particular, those of us privy to My Celebration Television, www.mycelebrationtv.com is the URL. Just in case you're wondering, that is a 24/7 station dedicated to your preaching, your teachings, your ministrations, and it does the job wonderfully. Not just for you, but in particular, for the settling of the house as well, your dear wife. Amen. Now, through your many preachings and things, we have heard quite a few call to actions from you, where you galvanize us into action. I can confirm, my father.
Right.
I can confirm if there's a man to pray. I can confirm these famous words from you as well. In fact, your first words to me, your time has
come.
Amen. We are also of late very privy to another saying from you. I think one of your book titles, it goes, you monitor me, you. Amen. And fifth and not the least, there's that very popular book. Well, I think it has been sold out. If it hasn't been, get your copy. I have mine. Amen. It's called That Which Must. Of all these things, we must ask of you, which is your favorite one? There's no joy. Please don't tell me what to say.
There's no cheating. It's like you just mentioned five mentors, I think.
Yes.
Okay, I have five children. It's like asking me which is my favorite child. Every pattern is there, is connected to the other one.
Amen.
When you say my father, it's the access code into prayer.
Amen.
My father is the access code to my time has come.
Amen.
It's the access code to the rich man's dad. So all of them are relevant.
Glory to God. A round of applause. Appreciate the second of the house. Amen. And of course, Celebration Television has made giant strides and continues to remain with the highest viewership on satellite and across the internet streaming platform. What next for Celebration TV? Are you intending on including special programming from the UK or more programs generally from particular pastors among your pastors here?
Okay.
Please tell us.
Celebration TV, as it were, is not a station, it's a situation.
Come on now!
The massive manifestations that we see, the ones we recognize, the ones we get a testimony, some of them, we actually have had issues where the dead people come back to life.
Absolutely. Amen.
Our life programs.
Amen.
And we are on several platforms, we are on ViewSat, we are on Galaxy, and we are having our meetings to come on Sky. That will be presently because of our platform Galaxy. People watch us on TV in Canada, in some parts of America, on TV, not on stream. So we do believe in God that between at the end of the year, we will to get that arrangement. Then on the television set, you can watch us in the UK.
Amen. A round of applause. Our time in UK has come. Amen. So far, you have two Omega Phi ministry in physical locations in London. You have one beautiful ministry in Manchester. In Manchester. In Manchester. In Manchester. In Manchester. Pastor Emmanuel. In Manchester. Amen. You have one in Birmingham. Amen. One in Birmingham. Amen. Amen. The two in London headed by the very able Pastor Reggie Rowe. Pastor Reggie Rowe. Pastor Reggie Rowe. And Pastor Megan. Amen. Amen. And one in Aberdeen. The question is, amen. One in Aberdeen. One in Aberdeen. Aberdeen. Amen. The question is, any other in the immediacy? Because Huddersfield wants to know. Bristol wants to know. Hull wants to know. Kent wants to know.
The Bible says that the glory of the knowledge of the Lord shall cover the earth as the water covers the sea. And when God spoke to us, it was a worldwide occasion. So the spread is on. The spread is on. Now, according to Manchester, literally, this meeting will metamorphose into other places. So get ready and just watch out. And Omega families will come to a location near you.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! A round of applause for that wonderful man. Now, final question. Your generosity has been very well spoken of. We watch you on celebration television, even here yesterday. A man was given a what? A very fat what? £1,000. That man, wherever you are, praise the Lord. Amen. Now, you have given cars, you have given millions, you blessed widows, blessed people with property, and absolutely. Much more than we can think or say or even know of. Absolutely. But the question that we are all asking is, why do you give so much? What's behind it? Can somebody give so much? Are you attempting to outdo Jesus? You give so much. Help us.
Okay. I don't know what I give. That's the truth, because initially I thought it was a revelation, maybe based on revelation. Contact from the Word of God until I discovered it. Even as a kid, my father told me that when I go to school, I come back naked.
Yes.
I give out my uniforms, I give out my shoes, I give out my stockings. So there was a time I came just on my inner pants, and my parents, we got a uniform. I said, young man, his short your tongue, his clothes your tongue, so I gave him mine. So one time, my father was going on a business trip. I was very young, and some lady came to the house. She was crying that she was a nursing mother, that she had a little baby that was about 2 months, and she needed to get some things for the baby, and she was hungry as well. So my father had no money except the capital for his business. He kept it in his wardrobe. So I saw him counting the money earlier on. So I sat in the living room, and I had to tell the woman, sorry, I can't help you. I have no money. So while they were talking, I went into the room and carried the whole capital and gave to the woman. So the woman, by then he had gone into the room. So the young man said, thank you, God bless you. So he came and said, what happened? He saw the money. He said, no, woman, when I say I have no money, I actually meant I had no extra money from you, this woman. And my father beat the living daylight out of me. So it's a part of my life. I can't stand people being uncomfortable.
Yes.
I can't stand people lack. I can't stand people in pain. I like generally seeing people happy. It's just a part of my life. Amen. And I cannot explain why. Sometimes it amazes me.
As we have heard before, leadership starts from the top. And nothing is for confirmed Apostle Joseph Suleiman as the true leader that he is. It's not by mere action or words. Amen. It's also by practice. Amen.